Hi. Before FinTech, let me introduce you to TUI. So, who are we? I think that's what you can see on our company presentation in the internet, right? It says we are a vertically integrated travel company and we scale globally. We cover all parts of the value chain. We have 20 million customers in sales and marketing. We have some 13 million customers which we bring on our own aviation. We operate 145 aeroplanes in 6 airlines. We are in destination, so in more than 100 countries of the world. We provide our customers with service. We have coaches and bring customers to the hotels and so on. And we also operate 324 hotels. I think right now it should be more than 340. And we have 16 cruise ships. And the interesting thing here is that we are scaling globally, so we have clearly defined how we want to operate. We said everything is local, but we have some integrated global platforms. That's the reason why we are together. It is brand, it is IT, it is aviation. So when we buy and finance aeroplanes, 145 makes it the number 7 airline in Europe. When we buy and finance aeroplanes from Boeing, we want to do it as one. We plan hotels and cruises and destinations. We have now more than 100 hotels in Caribbean. Now is Southeast Asia, the biggest gold grab right now, Thailand, Malaysia, Maldives and Mauritius and so on. So that's what we want to do together, and TUI Destination Service also clear. So when people come into destination, they should see one TUI. So that's what you see on our company website. But I want to give you another perspective how you could see our company as well. You could actually say we have 20 million customers of a value of 800 euro each, right? And we are serving, you know, from booking to holiday countdown, so until they leave, airport, flight, hotels and cruises, and flights. And what actually Glenn was talking about, you know, that he has a lot of data. We also have a lot of data because we are everywhere in the value chain. I would argue we know not only what customers book, but we also know what customers do. Now, if you want to increase right now the value, what could you be doing? Now, the first thing you could be saying and doing is when you collect 800 euro per customer of the 20 million, you could work on cash conversion. So what do you get out of the customer? And we started originally as trading companies. And trading, when you do a trading, you work on margin. And you typically, a trading margin in that field was 20 euro per 800 euro, which you could keep, right? 2.5% roundabout. Now, we increasingly invest, develop, invest, and operate hotels, and when customers go in our own hotels, we collect 120 euros per customer. And with cruise ships, it's even better, because with cruise ships, we collect 400 euros per customer. So by operating risk capacity and using our funnel when we sell to fill our own hotels and cruises, we significantly improve our profits. We came from a trading company, and now last year we had the first time where actually we had more profits in hotels and cruises than we had in trading. This had also another advantage, because when the internet comes, trading is always the bookings and the Trivagos. The trading gets under pressure, but of course when you have a bed, also a booking customer needs to sleep in a bed, right? So we understand and we think of ourselves as a hotel and cruise company with a direct sales. We can use booking, but we don't need booking, okay? So this is one of the things. The other thing how you could increase the potential value is actually the revenue per customer. And we have right now put all our customer data in the cloud. Everything is actually once there. We have, you know, one-to-one CRM systems. We can now at every customer touchpoint, steer the right offer, so next best activity, and you can see all the touchpoints here. So when a customer comes in, he gets his document in his app. As soon as he looks in the app, we start providing cross-selling, upselling, you know, room upgrades or tours in destination, and so on and so on. And when the customer then gets into, you know, usually, for example, when customers stand in front of the counter of the hotel to check in, that is the best point to provide room upgrades. And of course, if we have a junior suite available, you know, it comes at zero cost and every revenue is equals margin. So we have now, you know, 20 million customers at 800 euro, and it should be, I think, easy to go to 850 or 880. And of course, what we call ancillary margins are pretty high. So that's one way of looking at us. And that's a different way than, of course, in our corporate presentation. Now, another way of looking at us is that we have 90 million risk capacity in bed nights. That is our own and committed hotels. And 15 million risk capacity in flight seats. And we are, as you can see, for that, we are not actually a trading company. Here we own risk, so we don't earn margins. We operate yields. And the yield system now is running across our offering, fully integrated, and is recalculating all prices every hour based on the last hour's booking. And it's actually trying to optimize the yield curve over time. And that's, I think, very clear that when you want to get 20 million customers in the risk capacity of 90 million bed nights, it is enormous process heavy. And what we did right now is we threw away all our own data centers to calculate that. We put all our inventory on blockchain and in the cloud. That is more cheap, more high performant, and it is accessible from everywhere. So this is a pure cost equation. That's very easy. It's not anything where we wanted to disrupt any market or wanted to fight any competition. Now, the next thing we did is actually we made this blockchain available, inventory available to new markets. And when you think, for example, China, and you get for your Thailand hotel just a 2% or 3% additional occupancy for your hotel in Thailand, then you, of course, have a certain margin and a certain yield for that hotel. But more important is you lower the yield pressure also for your core business, because if you have to yield less, then already the first price or the price for the first hotel room can be higher, because you always think when you start pricing, can I sell the last hotel bed, which I actually need to sell in order to create sufficient occupancy? So if you get, you know, that kind of additional market presence, it also increases significantly, and this is actually the main purpose, the yield revenues or the yield margins also in our core businesses. And the last one I want to show is actually the potential, and that is maybe two years ahead or 3 years ahead. What actually I said to China, we could also do right now with all other markets. So we could, for example, open our blockchain, which is today private, to all other players, OTAs, travel agencies, or even to customers directly. And the interesting thing here, again, it is lowering the yield pressure and it actually will generate higher margins in our hotels and cruises. The interesting thing here is, I think, that in the blockchain, which I think will be the next internet, we don't need to earn money. And therefore, it will be very difficult for intermediaries like bed banks and so on to really have sustainable business cases, because we just have it there in order to have better yield functions and create more margins in our risk capacities. So with that said, initially there was a question, can we survive as a old travel company which has been there for ages in the internet world? And I would say, I don't feel so bad. The race is open. Let's see who will be there afterwards. Thank you.
Thank you very much.